Six kinds of loving exchanges.
那么其中呢就有六项交流爱心的活动.
In traditional cultures of the world, like India and China.
那是在那个传统的古老的文化，比方说像印度啊、中国这种古老文化.
There are natural relationships that exist. For example.
那它呢就有自然具有这种人和人之间的那种交往的那种方式
Between family members,
比方说家人之间,
the elders and children,
长者和孩子之间,
between government officials and citizens,
官员和这个臣民之间,
and in so many different ways there are types of relationships.
人们呢就是以各种各样的方式在交往.
Now we learn today about how devotees should exchange with each other, relate with each other.
那今天呢，我们就要解释奉献者彼此之间应该怎么样的，就是互相交流爱心.
The word priti, which we have here, priti means love.
那在这个诗里面的梵文，那个 priti 的意思是爱。
There is a difference between love and duty.
那在爱和这个责任之间，它是有区别的.
A duty is something that you are obliged to perform.
那个责任呢，是你必须要去履行的.
But love is something which comes more naturally and involves the emotions of the heart.
那这个爱呢，它是发自内心的一种情感.
The word duty is also connected with law.
那这个责任呢，这个词它跟法律也是相连的.
But love transcends the law.
但是呢，那个爱它超越法律.
For example, supposing that a young man breaks the law and comes to the house of his parents for protection.
那就比方说一个年轻人，他呢就是做了一些违法的事情，然后他就找他的父母去求取庇护.
Will the parents hide the boy?
那个他的父母会把孩子藏起来吗？把这个少年藏起来?
Or will they hand the boy into the
还是他们就是把这个孩子就是犯法的这个他们的孩子就直接就带到拉到那个警察局里去了.
Probably they will protect him.
他说最有可能的是就会保护他，把他藏起来.
That means that love is higher than the law.
这就意味着那个爱呢，它比那个法律要高.
We have to follow the law, but at a certain point we have to develop something greater than duty, and that is love.
那我们呢要遵循法律，但是呢，我们也应该就是培养比责任要更高的那个东西，那就是爱。We
are practicing bhakti yoga.
我们呢现在正在练奉爱瑜伽。
And Bhakti Yoga has two divisions.
那个奉爱瑜伽呢, 有两种形式。两个部分。
The first is Vaidhi Bhakti.
那第一个部分呢, 叫 Vaidhi Bhakti, 奉爱。
How come you don't translate that?
Vaidhi
Bhakti. Yeah, but you didn't find it. You're just using the sound. Okay. Which Vaidhi comes from the word Vidhi, which means rules.
那个梵文 Vaidhi 的意思是那个规则。
We have so many rules to follow. Just like when you come in front of the deity, you should bow down.
那我们呢要遵循很多的规则，就像比方说我们到神像面前必须要礼拜一样。
This is a rule.
这个是一个规定。
But that rule doesn't tell you how you should feel.
但是呢，这个规定并没有说你应该怎么样去实行。
But the idea is that by following the rule, if the rule is a good rule, then the feeling will gradually, naturally come.
那个规定本身并没有情感在里头，但是如果我们能够就是很好的遵循这些个正确的规律的话，这些规定的话，我们自然而然就会培养出爱情感。You
have seen in the temple room, Radha and Krishna and the gopis.
那我们在那个庙堂里头看到了那个神像 Radha, 这个 Krishna 还有牧牛姑娘们。
We understand that Krishna is God.
我们理解 Krishna 他是神。
And Radha is the energy of God.
而 Radha 呢，它是神的能量。
In a sense, they are not in a sense, but they are together. Radha and Krishna together are the supreme.
Radha 和 Krishna 在一起就是至尊的。
And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the combined form of Radha and Krishna.
而 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他就是 Krishna 和 Radha Rani 的结合。
Perhaps you have seen on the altar, if you go up close, the smaller deities of Radha, Madhava, and Chaitanya. Have you taken them up front as well?
Oh, 就是如果我们 看到那个神坛上那个大的神像底下不是有三尊小神像吗？
So that teaches us that Lord Chaitanya is right next to Radha Madhava because Radha and Krishna together are Lord Chaitanya. And when they're separate, they're Radha and Krishna, and together they're Lord Chaitanya.
那三尊小神像里头，一尊是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 另外两尊就是那个 Madhava 和 Radha， 也就是 Krishna 和 Radha。 那这三尊神像摆在那儿，就是要告诉我们说 ，Radha 和 Krishna 他们合起来就是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 他们分开就是 Krishna 和 Radha。
Radharani is the greatest lover of Krishna.
那个 Radharani 她是 Krishna 最爱。
She loves Krishna so much that sometimes Krishna, to understand what the feelings of Radharani is, Krishna thinks the only way I will understand Radharani's feelings is if I can take her position and be in her mood.
Radharani 呢，她也最爱 Krishna， 所以她是那么的爱 Krishna， 有的时候就要让 Krishna 想说她为什么那么爱我，为了要明白她为什么那么爱我，她就必须要以她的那个就是。 就是心态显现来体验 Radharani 对他的爱。
So when Krishna meditates very deeply like this on Radharani, Krishna's body turns golden color, which is the color of Radharani.
那当 Krishna 就那么深深的冥想有关 Radharani 的时候，他的肤色就变成了金黄色，而这个金黄色的肤色就是 Radharani 的肤色。
And that golden Krishna is Lord Chaitanya.
而变成了金黄色肤色的这个 Krishna， 他就是主 Chaitanya。
Inside is Krishna.
他在内在他是 Krishna。
And outside is Radharani.
外在他是 Radharani。
That's Lord Chaitanya.
这个就是主 Chaitanya。
So when we look at Radha and Krishna, Radha Madhava and the gopis, they all have very natural love.
那当我们看那个神像，就是Radha、Madhava还有那些个牧牛姑娘的时候，我们可以看到他们的面部表情都是有一种自然的爱。
They don't serve each other because of any rules or laws.
他们并不是说因为要遵循某一种规律啊、守则呀、啊，才去互相为对方服务。They
serve each other due to loving feelings.
他们是因为就是有那个发自内心的对对方的爱而去服务对方。So
gradually, when our devotion becomes natural and follows the type of mood that they have. That is called Raghunam Devotee.
那如果我们逐渐的，就是那个对 Krishna 爱逐渐培养出来了以后，而且就开始像那些个牧牛姑娘等等，他们那种爱对 Krishna 的爱的话，那那个时候我们再进入就是奉爱瑜伽的另外一个阶段，叫 Raghunam。
So we have explained a little bit about natural love for Krishna. But in order to learn how to love Krishna naturally, we have to learn how to love Krishna's devotees.
那我们刚才讲了一点点就有关对Krishna的那个爱。那如果我们要培养出对 Krishna的爱的话，我们首先就要学习去爱 Krishna的奉献者。
We have explained something about the natural love for Krishna, but in order to love Krishna, we must also learn to love the devotees.
我刚才解释了一点点，就是对 Krishna 的那种发自内心的爱。但是如果想要培养对 Krishna 的爱的话，我们必须学习怎么样先爱 Krishna 的奉献者。
So this verse explains the six ways in which love can be. The shape in which love takes between devotees.
那在这个第四节诗里面就解释了奉献者之间怎么样进行这种爱心交流的方式。
The first word is dadati, to give charity.
那第一个词叫 dadati, 也就是布施。
Now, and in India, we know that to give charity, and in China also, I think, both cultures teach that to give charity is a very good thing.
那在这个印度，还有包括在我们中国的这种传统，让我们大家都知道，给布施是一件很好的事情。
The Bhagavad Gita explains that charity can be given in three different ways, in ignorance, in passion, and in goodness.
国家梵歌当中就解释说，布施呢有三种形，有激情型、善良型，还有愚昧型的布施。Ladies
in the back, can you hear everything clearly?
那在后面在座的那个师姐，能听得很清楚吗
？Close that door.
把那门关上。Better.
If you give, supposing somebody is begging on the street, you know, in India there are many people who beg on the street, right? And they're always going, you know. But sometimes they look quite healthy.
在那个印度啊，就是他就讲，如果有人在街上乞讨，我们怎么办？他说在印度，他说有不少人都是在街上，就是跟你做这个姿势，但是他们有时候看起来挺健康的。Even
in America, so many people are begging.
即使在美国，也是有很多人在街上乞讨。But
often we see that when they get some donation, they go and purchase some cigarettes or some liquor.
那 我们经常看到这些人当他拿到钱的时候他经常就是去买烟啊买酒
So to give such persons the money is in charity in the mode of ignorance. It does no good for them nor for you.
那么如果你给这种人布施的话就是属于愚昧属性的布施对对方没有好处对你也没有好处
On the other hand, something better is to give charity for good cause. Supposing you hear that we are going to help to build a school and we will give a donation for that purpose.
那比这个愚昧属性要强的呢就是比方说我们给一些个好的项目捐款比如要建一个什么医院人家要建医院我们就给那个项目捐款这个就属于学校捐款那这个就属于
And after giving that donation, they will put our name on a plaque in the school hall.
那如果呢，比方说我们给一个学校捐款的话，人家就会把我们的名字写在那个学校的那个什么碑上。
And everyone will know that we are very charitable.
然后呢，每个人都知道我们是很乐善好施的。
That kind of charity is better than the first, but it is still not perfect. It is called charity in the mode of passion, because you are still expecting something in return.
这样的布施呢，它比那个愚昧型的布施要好，但是它还是不完美的，因为我们在布施的时候，我们是希望人家给我们回报。
You are doing it for name and fame.
我们是为了那个名声啊，自己的名声去做的。
On the other hand, what is charity in the mode of goodness?
那么什么是善良型的布施呢?
You should be careful about the sun.
说你应该小心太阳。
Your nose has become red.
你的鼻子变成红的。
Don't get too much sun. Keep a hat on.
戴个帽子，不要照太多的太阳。
Because your skin is very fair, you can get used to burn.
他说因为你的那个皮肤很白呀，所以容易被灼伤。
Everybody should drink a lot of water in this weather.
在这样的天里头，每个人都应该喝很多的水。
But make sure it's good water.
但是一定要喝那个干净的水。
Don't become dehydrated.
不要到时候就是身体缺水了，就不好。
Everybody's health is okay?
到现在为止，大家身体都好吗？
So, charity in the mode of goodness means to give to a proper person at the proper time, in the proper way.
那个善良型的布施就是意思是在适当的时间给予那个适当的人以一种适当的方式给予。
No expectation of name and fame.
而且呢，在给予的时候，没有任何期望说通过给这个自己变得出名了。
For a proper cause.
或者说是，它是应该是一个就是为了一个好的项目去给人。
This is charity in the mode of goodness.
这个就是属于善良型的布施。
But Prabhupada suggests another type of charity, even beyond this.
但是呢，帕布帕德建议我们有一种比 这三种型的布施更都好的布施
In the Chaitanya Charitamrita
在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 里面
In the teachings of Lord Chaitanya
在 Chaitanya 的教导里面
Which book will soon be published already published Oh yeah, you have the book In the teachings of Lord Chaitanya You will find a chapter about Ramananda Roy
那个在柴卡亚的教导里头，我们会找到有关 Ramananda Roy 那一章节。
And in the discussion, the question is asked, who is the most charitable person?
那在这个彼此之间的讨论当中呢，就谈到了一个问题，说谁是最好。
And this is what Prabhupada is going to speak about when he says, what is the best form of charity? The best charity is to distribute Krishna consciousness to others. To give knowledge, to give the teachings of Krishna consciousness to another person is the highest charity of all.
给予 Krishna 意识的知识和教导, 把这个给予每一个人, 这个是最高的,
it doesn't cost any money.
而这个也不需要花什么钱.
It's very easy. No one can say, I cannot afford it.
那这是一个很容易的方法, 没人说我,
and it is the most valuable gift that you can give.
而这个是你能给予他人的最有价值的礼物.
So, similarly to receive gifts.
同样的, 还有就是怎么样接受礼物.
Pratigrinati, to accept something in return.
那个梵文, Pratigrinati的意思就是接受那个.
These are ways of loving exchanges between devotees, to give a gift, to receive a gift.
这个就是奉献者之间交流爱心的那种方式, 赠送礼物, 接受礼物.
Just like this morning, Janava gave me a gift. 像今天早上,Janava给他一个东西。哦。谢谢。Counter beads.
这个是那个属珠啊。
Amber, so this is a loving exchange, to give a gift. She gave me the gift, I accepted the gift. These are two ways of loving exchange.
那我给她礼物,
so we can do like this between devotees. If we know a devotee, if we feel something for someone, we can give them a gift.
所以我们彼此之间的就可以这么做。当我们觉得有一个什么东西挺适合对方的啊, 我们就把这个给他。
Just like you must have many friends who could not come to India this year.
就像在座的各位肯定都有很多的朋友今年呢来不了印度。
You can purchase them a sari.
那你呢就可以送给他们一件 sari 呀。
Or a dhoti.
或者一件 dhoti 呀。
And bring it back and give them a gift.
去买了这个以后作为礼物就给他们。
That's a way of showing your love.
这个就是你向他们表达你对他们的爱的那种方式。
This is the idea behind this. This is the point. Then the next thing is guyam akyati prichi. Guyam akyati prichi. Guyam means something which is private or secret.
那个梵文 guyam 的意思是那种机密的话题。
Prabhupada translates it confidential.
对，那啪啪的就翻译成就是机密的。
Use the same word, but you see, that's not exactly what I see.
秘密，机密啊。
That's all right. First, I said secret.
Oh, secret. 秘密。
Not the same.
Okay.
It's a little different.
有一点点区别了，秘密和机密一点点区别。
So, this is going to be more, this is not easy for this is not such an easy thing to do, to explain, let's see how to say, to talk with another person about your inner feelings.
就是说在私下向对方吐露自己的心声，这个不是一件容易做的事情。Now,
before we go to that, we will say that this may mean to speak, to show love to another person is to talk to them about Krishna.
那当然了，在说这个之前，我们就说，如果要是向一个人表示这个爱心的话，你最好就是说向对方谈有关 Krishna。
And from the other side, to hear someone speak to you about Krishna consciousness.
那另外一方面呢，你是聆听对方跟你讲有关 Krishna.
So, devotees should speak always together about Krishna consciousness.
奉献者应该总是彼此之间谈论有关 Krishna 意识的事。
The two most important principles of devotional service are hearing and chanting.
奉爱服务的最重要的两条原则就是聆听和吟诵吟唱。
So hearing and chanting together, just like in the evening we are having kirtan.
那聆听和吟诵吟唱，这就像我们每一天晚上在一起kirtan一样。
And just like now, we are hearing and chanting. Somebody is speaking, somebody is hearing. This is what is described here.
也就像现在这样，也是吟诵、吟唱、聆听。有的人在讲，我们有的人在听。
But we should also be willing to reveal to another person any problem or doubts that we may have in the practice of Krishna consciousness.
但是呢，我们也应该想要，就是说，在培养 Krishna
意识的过程当中，我们就是遇到什么问题呀，有什么心事啊，我们也应该想要去跟某人去吐露心声。没有看，没有看，没有看。对对。 This is called offense. Dropping a heavy bar in the head of another devotee. So we should be willing to have our doubts removed. But I think that this is not very easy to do.
但是我认为这个呢，不是那么容易做的事情。Because
generally we do not like to expose our weaknesses to another person.
因为一般的情况下，我们都不愿意把自己的弱点向别人展露出来。They
may take advantage of us.
要不然的话，人家可能就会趁机利用我们呀。They
may tell other people about what problems we have.
人家可能就是说，把我们告诉他的这个我们有的问题去告诉别人呐。
So generally, we keep our problems and weaknesses to ourselves.
所以一般的情况下，我们都是把问题和我们的弱点都藏在心里。
And we only show our good face.
我们总是把我们的好的一面给大家看。
Just like when you wake up in the morning, you don't look very good.
就像每天早上大家起床的时候，肯定看起来不那么好看。
But after properly bathing and putting on some tilak.
但是呢，就是说，洗好了澡以后啊，把提拉克放在化好以后，
and the ladies put on other things.
那那个女士们再放点其他的东西在脸上，
then everything looks much better.
然后就是脸就看着就好多了。
So nobody likes to be seen early in the morning after getting out of bed.
所以呢，没有人就是刚起床的时候就想让别人给看见。
In the same way, nobody likes to have their inner problems shown outside.
那同样的方式，我们也都不愿意把自己有的那些个问题呀，就是给大家展示在大家面前。
But in the morning, if you don't wash your face, then how will you become clean and look good?
那如果早上，但是呢，如果早上起来我们不洗脸的话，不洗澡的话，我们怎么可能看起来好看呢？
Similarly, if you don't get rid of the problems and doubts that are inside, then how will you ever become free from them?
那同样的道理，如果我们不把我们有的问题、疑问从我们心中给它去除掉的话，那怎么能够就说变得更好呢？
So we must develop close relationships with our fellow devotees based on trust.
那我们呢？因此，我们必须要跟那些个就是成熟了的奉献者去交往，建立一个好的关系，而且要对他们怀有信心。Where
we can speak to another person and feel confident that they will not expose our doubts or problems, but will help us over them.
那那个，我们应该找到那样的人，我们可以把我们的心事啊。 疑问呐、啊、都讲给他听，而他呢不会就是用这个来利用我们或者是跟别人讲，他相反的会帮助我们解决所有的问题。
Best is that you choose someone. And there's two things. One is that you talk with people who are as advanced as you are, and another is if you speak to persons who are more advanced.
那在这样做的时候有两种方式，一种呢就是跟我们一个层面的人去讲这些，另外一种呢就是要去跟比我们进步的多的人去讲。
Both are good.
这两样都是好的。
Both are
good. 都是好的。
What is the, those who are more advanced should explain to those who are newer how they themselves make advancement in spiritual life, how they have been able to advance.
那些个更进步的人，他应该跟比较初级的人呢，要解释自己当时就是是怎么样的取得进步的，一直以来是怎么取得进步。
We should not keep our understand. We should not.Be miserly about Krishna consciousness. We should be willing to share with others everything that we ourselves have understood and know. But we should choose the proper person to share it with.
我们呢不应该特别的吝啬，就是去跟别人分享我们那个培养Krishna意识的经验等等，我们学到的知识，我们的理解，我们不应该吝啬。那我们应该是能够愿意去跟大家分享，但是我们应该挑那个合适的人去分享。
Supposing you are a cook and you know a recipe, and you think I'm not going to tell anyone else because I'm the only one who knows this recipe.
假如我们是一个厨师，我们知道一个特别好的菜谱。我们呢不愿意跟任何人讲，我们就想这个是我，这个菜谱是我是唯一知道的。
No, we should teach if it's a good recipe, we share it freely.
那这个就是吝啬，我们不应该这么做。我们如果是一个好的菜谱的话，我们应该跟大家分享。
Just like yesterday, I was invited to eat some pizza.
那就像昨天我就是被邀请去吃披萨。
So, the person who invited me showed me.A list of offenses against pizza.
昨天就是请我去吃披萨的那个人呢，就给了我整个的列了一个单子，就是怎么样，就是对那个披萨不好的那些冒犯披萨的那些条。
And one of the offenses is to not teach the pizza recipe to other people.
其中一项对披萨的冒犯是把那个披萨的那个菜单那个菜谱去告诉其他人。啊，对啊，那个就是冒犯了。
You should be willing to share the knowledge.
啊，就说如果不想告诉其他人，这是一种冒犯，应该是想把这个菜谱告诉其他人。
So if you have understood something that has benefited you about Krishna consciousness, you should not keep it to yourself thinking, this way I will be more advanced than the others. But you should offer that knowledge and help to everyone freely.
那当我们在这个培养 Krishna 意识的过程当中取得进步以后，我们不应该就是说把我们所取得的经验就像一个吝啬鬼似的不告诉其他人，认为这样的话自己就会比别人进步了。不，我们应该把我们所得到的那些个经验都去告诉大家。
Our teaching is to learn how to be servants.
我们的教导是要学习怎么样成为仆人。
Not masters.
不是主人。
The guru does not think of himself as the master, but thinks of himself as the servant of his students.
那个灵性导师，他不认为自己是那个主人，是老师，他是认为自己是他的学生的仆人。
Just like the parents, they serve their children.
就像父母亲，他们是为他们的孩子做服务。
Parents are in a superior position to children, and but still they're the servants of their children.
尽管父母是比这个孩子年长要高，啊，但是呢，他们是为孩子做服务。
So to be a servant is the best position.
因此成为仆人是最好的地位。
And to be a servant of the servant is even a better position.
那成为仆人的仆人，那就是更好的地位。
And to be a servant of the servant of the servant is still better.
那成为仆人的仆人的仆人，那就是更好了。
That means humility is the most important quality of a Vaishnava.
这意味着就是说，那个谦卑呀，是 Vaishnava 主 Krishna 的奉献者的最好的品格。
Just like it is said that a tree which bears the most fruit bows the lowest.
就像我们有句话说的，那个树上长的那个果实越多的那个树，它的腰弯的越低。
And a tree that has no fruit that stands up very tall.
那个没有果实的那个树，它是胸膛挺的，挺直直的。
So the fruit that we are speaking about is love for Krishna.
那我们谈到的这个果实呢，是对 Krishna 的爱。
And Lord Chaitanya considers himself to be a gardener.
那个主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他认为自己是一个园丁。
He says that he has planted this tree.Of Krishna Bhakti.
他说他呢种下了这棵对 Krishna 的爱 Krishna Bhakti 这棵树。
And now there are so many fruits of love for Krishna which are growing on this tree, and he is in anxiety how to distribute all these fruits.
那现在呢，这棵树上长出了那么多的对 Krishna 的爱的那种果实。Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他就感到很焦虑了，他应该怎么样赶快的把它们发出去呢？
So whoever considers himself to be a follower of Lord Chaitanya should relieve Lord Chaitanya of this burden of the fruits, the burden or anxiety he feels by helping him to distribute the fruits of Krishna consciousness.
那么任何一个认为自己是主 Chaitanya 的这个追随者就应该赶快的把对 Krishna 的爱这些个果实赶快的发出去，这样可以帮助 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 减轻负担。
It is said that the fruits of love for Krishna are so sweet, sweeter than any mango.
那个经典里就曾经说过，对 Krishna 的爱这种果实是那么的甜美，比任何的芒果都要甜。
It is a fruit that has practically no.Very small pith and very thin skin.
那这种这个那个芒果那种水果呢是一层薄薄的皮，完了有一个小核，
那个籽
特别脆。对 Krishna 的爱那个果实啊，它是籽特别的小，皮特别的薄。
And it is full of juice.
而且呢是充满了汁液。
So, of course, if you pick a mango before it becomes ripe.
那当然了，就是说在那个芒果成熟前，我们摘芒果的话。
Then you don't get the full sweetness of the mango.
那你就不会得到那种就是特别甜的那种芒果。
So, the fruits of love for Krishna, each one of us must.It is described that we must allow the mango to ripen fully.
那经典就是说，我们应该要等到就是让那个芒果成熟，完全的成熟。对 Krishna 的爱也是这个样子。
In order to get the full sweetness of the taste.
这样的话，我们才能够得到就是完全的、完美的那种甜的滋味。
That means that the process of Krishna consciousness has to take time to mature or ripen.
那这就意味着说，培养 Krishna 的这个意识的这个路啊，我们需要就是说有一段时间才能够变得成熟。
You cannot expect to immediately taste the sweetness of Krishna consciousness. It may take some time, as a mango takes time to ripen.
就像芒果，它需要时间才能够成熟，培养 Krishna 意识也一样。我们不要说期望好像我们马上就能够品尝到那个甜美的滋味，但是需要一段时间以后我们才能够品尝到。
Wake up. Everybody should stay awake.
大家都能不能清醒一下，每个人都应该保持清醒。
Sometimes if we are sitting too comfortably we may fall asleep.
有的时候如果我们坐得太舒服的话，我们就会到时候就睡着了。
There is an advantage to sitting on the floor.
所以呢，这个就是坐在地上就有这个好处，比较不容易睡着。
Because not very comfortable.
因为这个地上不是那么的舒服。
I have seen people who have fallen asleep while lecturing.
我看到人就是打那个在讲课的时候就打瞌睡。
I won't mention the person's name.
我不会提那个人的名字是谁。
But he was a very prominent member of this country sometimes, and he used to sometimes. Many people fell asleep listening to the lecture, but he even fell asleep giving
them.他说那个很多人就是在听课的时候呢，就有的人就睡着了。但是有一个人，他说我不会提他的名字。他呢，在这个国际Krishna意识协会里头已经很长时间了。他不仅仅是听课的时候睡着，他讲课的时候也睡着了。One
time, Prabhupada was giving a lecture in Gorakhpur. It's a city in somewhat near Vrindavan.
Oh, 有一次，帕布哈德就是在那个离文达文比较近的一个城市里面就给讲课。
So his servant was feeling very tired.
那他的帕布哈德仆人当时觉得很累。
The floor was a wooden floor he was sitting on.
那我们当时他们坐的那个地板呢，是那个木地板。
And everybody was listening very carefully to Prabhupada, and the room was very quiet. And suddenly we heard this very big sound. The servant had fallen on and hit his head on the floor. Then he woke up. Papa said, now go to sleep. So, Bhagavad Gita has taught us that we have to practice patience.
那个国家梵歌里就告诉我们说，我们应该就是很耐心的在练奉爱。
And we also heard this from third verse, the previous verse talked about being patient.
那我们在第三节诗，我们前一次讲那节诗里头也听到，应该要耐心。
See, now it is easy because many of you are very new devotees.
那现在呢，我们在座的各位就是大家，有很多人都是新的奉献者，因此好像比较容易。
When children are 2 or 3 years old, life is easy.
那孩子在两三岁的时候，生活对他们来说是很容易的。
Of course, they fall and they scrape their arm and get a little hurt, but other than that, no much problem.
尽管呢，他们有的时候摔倒，然后呢，就是蹭破一点胳膊上的皮呀等等的，但是整个来说，生活对他们是很容易的。
But as you get older, you have to go to school, and then the problem gets more difficult.
但是呢，当我们长大一些以后，我们必须要去学校，我们的问题就多了。
And then you have to get married, and there's further problems.
然后，如果我们要结婚的话，我们的问题就更多了。And
life goes on, and problems increase.
随着这个生活的继续，问题越来越多。So
you are all in a very nice stage because so far there's not much problems.
那你们现在大家呢，基本上都是在很好的一个阶段，因为到现在为止还没有很多的问题。But
you'll see. Within 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, it will become more difficult.
但是大家将会看到，在今后的6个月里面，1年、2年、3年、5年里面，问题会越来越。
It won't get easier.
不会越来越容易的。
Because you will realize, by then you will have much more knowledge, and you will realize so much more. How much you have to do to become Krishna conscious?
因为呢，随着大家对这个培养 Krishna 意识知道的越来越多，就会觉悟到你有更多的事情要做。If
you can embrace, if you can hold on to the teachings of books like this, this will help you later on.
如果我们大家能够紧紧的抓住我们的书这个老师不放的话。
When those problems come, you'll be able to talk to another person to help you through those problems.
当有问题来的时候，如果我们能够跟其他的一位人，一个人讲我们的问题的时候，那他就会帮助我们解决问题。The
last, so I have spoken about four types of loving exchange.
那我刚才呢已经讲了有四种这个爱心的交流。To
give a gift, to receive a gift.
赠送礼物，接受礼物。
We also said the word charity, right?
对,
give charity.
对，当我们也说了布施，接受布施。And
to speak confidentially and to hear confidentially.
还一个呢，就是要这个在私下里面跟人家讲自己的心事，在私下里面听别人的心事。So
that's four. Now there's two more left.
这已经是四个了，还有两项。And
these two are very easy.
而这两项是很容易的。To
offer prasada and to receive prasada.
给别人吃 prasada， 接受人家给我们的 prasada。
I have always said, just like Gopal Raj cooks for me so much, I always told him that in prasada, 50% is in cooking and 50% is in serving the prasada.
那个 Gopal 他常年的侍奉 Gurudev 就是给他做 prasada， 那 Gurudev 就跟他讲。 就有关 prasada 50%呢是做 50%是侍奉
Just like in England, he was cooking for me.
就是在伦敦的英国的时候，他就被有Gurudev做饭。
And there were two other people living there.
那还有两个人也跟他们住在一起。
But I would not let them serve the prasada.
那两个跟他们住在一起的人，那个Gurudev就不允许他们给他侍奉 prasada.
Because their mood was not right.
因为他们的那个心态不对。
The main thing about serving prasadam is that you have to serve prasadam just like a mother feeds her baby.
那个在侍奉别人吃 prasadam 的时候，那个心态啊，应该是母亲喂孩子的心态。
When a mother is feeding her child, the mother is not thinking about eating herself. She's only thinking that the child should eat more.
那当那个母亲喂孩子吃饭的时候，她当时不会想要自己吃，她唯一想的是怎么让孩子能够多吃一点。She's
not thinking I better save something for myself.
她不会想说我最好先给我自己留下一点。She's
not distracted thinking about something else.
那个时候她也不会去让别的事情打扰她的心。She's
only thinking how can I get my child to eat nicely and be healthy.
她唯一想的就是我怎么才能够让我的孩子能够多吃一点而且快乐。
That kind of serving is good.
这样的这个侍奉菩萨的心态是对的。
But that's very hard to learn if you don't feel that way.
但是呢，如果我们心里面没有那种母子的那种情感的话，那很难就是学习的。
In some temples, in temples sometimes, the persons who serve the prasadam are the senior most people.
在世界各地的某一些庙里面，侍奉 prasadam 的人，就给别人派 prasadam 的人，都是更年长的奉献者。Because
they're more advanced, they can give more freely and easily.
因为由于他们更进步，他们就心态里面就更容易给人家多一点，就是不是想自己。In
your cooking and in your serving of the prasadam, the love has to pass through.
在你做 prasadam， 还有在你派 prasadam 的时候，就是侍奉 prasadam 的时候，那个你的心中的爱必须通过这些活动表现出来。Just
like sometimes there are you can see there are restaurants with expert cooks, but you cannot eat that food because there's no love in the cooking.
就是说，你看，比方说有一些个餐厅，尽管那个厨师特别的高级，但是你吃你又不想吃，为什么？因为他在做饭的时候，他没有那种爱的情感。
So, this preparation of prasadam and serving of prasadam must be done with a loving mood and a giving mood.
因此，做 prasadam 还有就是侍奉 prasadam 必须是以一种爱的心态，以一种给予的心态去做。
Prabhupada called prasadam our secret weapon.
帕布帕德叫把这个 prasadam 叫做秘密的武器。
If we are talking about when we use the word weapon, it means warfare.
那当我们一谈到武器的时候，就意味着是要打仗。Now
we are making war with Maya.
我们呢是在跟玛雅错觉能量在做斗争。
A material civilization.
就是物质的那些个设施,
and the secret,
物质文化,
and the secret weapon is prasada.
而跟物质那种文化做斗争的秘密的武器就是 prasada.
People who do not agree with our philosophy,
那些个不同意我们的哲学的人,
they still like our prasada.
他们还是喜欢我们的 prasada.
So prasada can go where the philosophy cannot go.
所以呢, prasada们能去的地方, 他, prasada们能够去那个哲学去不到的地方。
Prabhupada told me the last year when he was living, he said to me, we don't need to open more temples like in America where we had many temples. We don't need more temples in America. We should just open restaurants.
当帕布巴德离开这个世界的前一年的时候，他就告诉古瑞德说：“说我们不需要再在世上就要开更多的庙，我们更需要的是要开很多的餐厅。”
So I think in Taiwan there are many vegetarian restaurants, Buddhist restaurants.
那他说他认为就是在台湾呢，就有很多的那个素食都是佛教的素食啊餐厅。
But there are no prasadam restaurants.
但是还没有 prasadam 的餐厅。
So this is something for the future.
所以呢，刚才就讲了六种爱心交流的方式。现在呢，我们有几分钟可以让大家提问题。 那个帕布就问说：“你刚才说，就是最好的布施的方式是把Krishna意识的知识给予他人，有关圣灵啊等等给予他人。那么要给予他人，我们需要什么样的资格？”
I have so many fond memories of our old days.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yesterday I was remembering you. At that pizza party, I only named you. I said, if only Manus had been
there.
And then I saw you. He's Italian. The qualification for distributing the holy name and Krishna consciousness is purity.
那个要就是把有关 Krishna 的圣名和知识给予他人所需要的资格是纯洁。Because
there are different types of chanting.
因为念 Hare Krishna 有不同的那个方法。If
the chanting is done offensively.
那个阶段是不一样的，如果是一种冒犯的在念。
There are different types of offenses to be avoided. If we don't avoid those offenses and we're on the offensive stage, the chanting that we give, the holy name and Krishna consciousness that we preach will not be nearly as effective. Here.
也就是说，那个念 Hare Krishna mantra 需要有很多的冒犯需要避免。那如果我们不去除这些弊， 如果我们不避免这些个冒犯的话，以这样就是怀着就是在冒犯的情况下念 Hare Krishna Mantra 的话，那我们再向别人传播这个知识或者是什么的，也不会有很大的影响力。
When you go to Vrindavan,
当你们去 Vrindavan 的时候，
you will go to the hill called Govardhan.
你们会去那个戈巴尔丹山。
And our dear godbrother Tetra Bharati Prabhu lives there.
那个 Tetra Bharati Prabhu 这个 Gurudev 的临近兄弟就住在那。
Tetra Bharati Prabhu is a very dear godbrother of mine. We have been working together for more than 25 years.
那这个帕布他是Gurudev 的特别亲爱的这个神兄弟，他们在一起工作已经25年多了。
As Giri Hari Manch and I have been working together so long, and he also.
就像那个Giri Hari Maharaj 和他在一起很长时间合作，他也一样。
Yeah, even longer.
他比那个Giri Hari Maharaj 还要长跟Gurudev 合作了，是不是？
We are very.Affectionate brothers.
他说我们是互相特别有感情的那个兄弟。
So we always, as soon as we see him, we become happy.
说一旦互相看到彼此，就特别的快乐。
And I hope you will also.
我希望你们也是。
So in preaching and in distributing the holy name, the more purified you are, the more effect will be there on others.
就是说在我们传播 Krishna 的圣名和有关培养 Krishna 意识知识的这个过程当中，我们有多纯洁，我们的影响力就有多大。
It is said that Lord Chaitanya and his associates were so pure that anyone who would come within a range of 80 miles could become pure devotee just by being in the near vicinity.
那这个经典里就说，主柴坦亚马哈巴布和他的那些个同游是那么的纯洁，那么有人呢，只要走进他们所在的地方的那个80公里的那个范围，80英里的那个范围，他马上就会变得纯洁，然后就要念哈利克什曼传。
How big is Taiwan?
台湾有多大
？How long?
有多长？
300 miles.
就是200英里吧。
So all we need is three pure devotees with one.
他说，所以我们就需要三个纯粹的奉献者放在不同的地方，就是台北、台中、高雄就好了，所有的人都是成为奉献者了。
But to make a pure devotee, to become a pure devotee, is not an easy thing.
但是要培养纯粹的奉献者，要成为纯粹的奉献者，那个不是这个容易的事情。
This is our godbrother Abhiram Prabhu.
这个是我们的神兄弟阿比。
Abhiram Prabhu. Another very. He and I have been together at Keshe Party also for, say, the same amount of time, 27, 28.
他也是跟 Gurudev 在一起合作已经差不多26、27年七八年那个样子。
He is a businessman.
他是个商人。
And a very good Vaishnava.
而且也是一位非常优秀的 Vaishnava 的奉献。
So, I can say.That when I was a new, before I joined the Krishna consciousness movement, my friend had a record of Prabhupada chanting Hare Krishna.
那他说，在他就是加入这个国际 Krishna 意识协会之前，是他的朋友就是在念 Hare Krishna 在介绍。
And just by hearing that record.
听到他的朋友听到了一个啪啪的唱片。
And just by hearing that Hare Krishna mantra chanted by Prabhupada, I became Krishna conscious.
那 Gurudev 仅仅通过听他的朋友放的那个啪不啪德吟诵吟唱 Hare Krishna mantra 的那个唱片，他就变成了。
Still, I could not join.
但是呢，他还是不能够加入这个运动。
Until I tasted prasada.
直到他吃了 prasada 以后，品尝了 prasada 以后。
So both were required.
所以呢，两者都需要。
It wasn't the philosophy was the third thing, but first was Prabhupada's chanting, second was prasada, And then third was reading the philosophy.
所以呢，一共有三项事情，但是第一项是那个念Hare Krishna mantra， 第二就是听那个啪啪啪的念，第二项就是吃 prasada， 第三项才是读哲学。
You wanted to say something about that?
I just wanted to mention how when the body sometimes you see books in different unfold like this.
Tirthirat Prabhu. Tirthirat Prabhu. Tirthirat Prabhu has added an important point.
Tirthirat Prabhu,
he says, even if you are not pure, but if you distribute books which are filled with the writings of a pure devotee,
但是如果你去把这个纯粹的奉献者所写的书给别人,
then the effect will be to purify the receiver of the book.
那那个力量也会能够净化接收那本书的人。
Mahendra Prabhu.
Should the recipes in the restaurant be also?
There's no problem. Even if you have a restaurant, you can give the recipe freely.
那这位软汉者法布就说，刚才你说要开餐厅，就是 prasada 餐厅。那如果我们开了 prasada 餐厅的话，那个我们有的那个菜谱是不是也可以免费的随便的给人家呢？
The secret is not in the recipe. The secret is in the consciousness of the cook.
他说，真正的秘密不在于那个菜谱，而在于那个做饭的人的意识。
One more question.
最后一个问题.
You mentioned two questions, Manasika. Yes.
You mentioned that our inner problem to discuss or share devotees. Sometimes they may get.
Wait, 1 minute. Come on, sir. This is Narishra Prabhu.
This is Narishra Prabhu.
He is the BBT trustee. For Taiwan.
他是那个台湾的 BBT 的那个公司的老板。
Any complaints you have about this, any complaints about the BBT managers may be brought to him.
你们大家谁对这个 BBT 的管理者有意见的话，
就去找他。 Or translators.
或者是对那个翻译有意见的话， 就去向他抱怨。
Again, he's another person who we have known for 25 years. This is family. He's also your family. These are all respectable elders. So, yes, what was the question?
You mentioned that we should share our inner problem with the devotee. Sometimes they may get tense over it. Is not your thing?
He says that if you have some problems and you tell them to another person, then the person themselves, the person who heard it, becomes burdened by the problem. Isn't that an offense to make that other person unhappy by telling them your problem?
他说刚才我们在说的那个爱心交流里头有一个就是向其他人吐露自己的心声，而有的时候呢，那个听你的人听了你的问题以后，自己就觉得焦虑啊，有负担了。那这样让别人焦虑、有负担、不快乐，这个是不是一种冒犯呢？
If a child has a problem, and the child goes to the parent, the parent accepts the problem because the parent loves the child. So because of love, we don't mind taking the burden of the problem of others.
如果孩子有问题，他就会去找他的父母。那他的父母因为他爱这个孩子，所以他不会说，因为就是说听了他这个问题以后，自己感到焦虑，就不愿意，他是愿意。 承担这些的焦虑。
This is called compassion.
这个叫同情。
And this is the highest way to attract the attention of Lord Chaitanya.
而这个具有同情心呢、啊，是最高的能够吸引主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的注意力的方式。
If you are willing to extend yourself to help others by accepting, by trying to help to relieve them of their problem, then they will be relieved and you will be relieved by the grace of Lord Chaitanya.
如果你有那种同情心，你愿意就是啊帮助其他人，听别人的问题，完了去帮助其他人，让人家能够减轻别人的痛苦的话，那到时候就会靠着主柴坦亚的仁慈，你就能够帮助其他人。
This is Amarendra Prabhu.
这一位叫 Amarendra
Prabhu. Amarendra Prabhu is the main lawyer of ISKCON who defends ISKCON in all legal matters.
那他这位法布呢，他是我们国际库什纳弟子协会里面的主要的律师。那外面当有人攻击我们的时候，他是最主要的保护我们这个协会的人。
Just like on the battlefield, there is a great warrior Arjuna.
就像在那个战场上有伟大的战士阿尔朱娜一样。
This is the Arjuna of this country.
这个是国际飞行员运动协会的阿尔朱
娜。Translate this.
He's also very humble.
他也非常的那个谦卑。
These are all close friends.Abhiram Prabhu was the president in the early days of the Miami Temple. He was the president of the Gainesville Temple. Both in Florida, two temple presidents of Florida in 1960s and 70s.
他们是1960s and 1970s那个佛罗里达州的两位那个庙长。
And if you read that book, Servant of the Servant,
如果大家读了《仆人的仆人》这本书的话，这一些人都在我们那个书里面。
They are part of this kind of history.
他们是那个国际奎什纳意识协会的历史的一部分。而现在没看出来是历史了，都快变成古董了。
We'll hold back the question now because the time is over. Tomorrow morning we will give the class in another location. You will learn about that. We are going to go to the Jagannath Mandir.